Hey guys, welcome at Away From Keyboard, and today we're talking about, is Titan Souls worth playing? Titan Souls is an indie game developed by Acid Nerve and published by Devolver Digital in 2015. It was released on the PlayStation 4, PlayStation Vita, PC, Mac and also Android devices.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know about that. Yeah, so how did you get to know Titan Souls?
Well, I came across it on Twitch. There was some guy playing it and it looked awesome. And I wanted to try it out for myself because it was really different from the other games I've played in the time. It kind of had a Zelda vibe, but yeah, it was way harder.
Yeah, so did you buy it at that time or?
No, I illegally downloaded it. And later on, when PlayStation Plus had it free, I downloaded it free.
Yeah. Well, it's a shame that these games don't get pushed in the list on in the PlayStation Store. Because I also found out because it was free in the PlayStation Store or with the PS Plus subscription. And I had no clue that this game was around, and if I knew, I would have bought it earlier.
Yeah.
Well, over to gameplay.
Yeah, well, like I said, it kind of has a Zelda vibe to it. It looks like an action RPG, from top down, but it isn't really an RPG. It kind of is like Zelda meets Dark Souls.
Yeah.
And then I'm talking about the old school Zelda on the Super Nintendo.
Right. You have only one objective.
Yeah, that's kill all the monsters.
Kill all the bosses. Yeah, it's a pretty big world for such a small game. The length of the game isn't really that long.
No.
Let's say it's about 6 hours or
I think around that. Yeah, I think we completed it faster, but because we had a lot of experience with the other bosses already.
Right. So if you're new, you get to complete it in 6 hours.
Yeah.
If you're good enough to kill those bosses, because some can be pretty hard. Well, the world is pretty big for such a small game, and it's divided in multiple areas, and in each area there are multiple bosses. Sometimes it's three, sometimes four or more. It increases by each area.
And the fun thing is you don't have to do it in a specific order. You can go to the boss you want to defeat, and after that go to another one.
Yeah, and these areas are locked, and they open up when you kill enough bosses in a specific area.
Yeah. This is one of those indie games where you die when you get hit once.
Yeah.
Some people don't like that, but it really works well in this game.
It does. The only problem with that is that if you die, you have to walk for a long time, sometimes.
Back to the boss.
Back to the boss. Which kind of sucks sometimes.
Yeah, well, I kind of think they did that on purpose, because otherwise it would be too easy. Because now you die, you get out of the action, and you really have to get into it again once you get to the boss. So sometimes you need some time to adjust yourself to the boss.
Yeah, well, if you don't, you get frustrated. That's now you have time to
cool off. Your character has a bow and arrow, and he only has one arrow. So if you shoot that arrow, yeah, well, good luck. You have to go grab that arrow again and shoot it again.
Yeah, but you don't really have to move towards it to grab it. You can pull it back. Which is also a mechanic, which is pretty fun to me, because you can also kill an enemy when pulling it back.
Most of the bosses can be killed also in one hit. Sometimes you have to do a specific thing before you can hit it, so that turns each boss into a puzzle.
Yeah, it does. Yeah,
you have to figure out how to kill it. For example, you have an ice cube. In the ice cube there's a brain, I think.
Yeah.
How are you going to kill the brain? Because your arrow doesn't go through the ice. You have to hit him at a specific time when he aligns with a little torch.
Yeah.
Shoot your arrow through it and light the bitch on fire.
Yeah, and the problem is that it sounds pretty simple, and sometimes it looks pretty simple, but it isn't simple at all.
No, it is really hard.
Yeah.
And that's where the Dark Souls comes into yeah, the titles.
It really does, it really does. Yeah, and another factor that made it pretty hard to me is that you, of course, have to draw your bow. You can't just shoot arrows. It really takes some time to draw your bow, and otherwise you won't get as far. And maybe you can kill it with a shot that only goes for, let's say, 3 meters or so. But yeah, most of the time it doesn't.
Besides that, you also got the roll to dodge enemy attacks. So yeah, it's really important to use that roll at the right times, because it can also get you into problems.
Yeah, you can't just spam it.
No. And don't roll on stairs.
Please don't. You won't be faster. And also, I think you can run. A lot of people don't know about this, but if you hold down the roll button or dodge button, you can run.
You can run
after doing a roll.
Yeah. In between the bosses, you are roaming around in the world. In this world, there are also puzzles. Sometimes you have to complete these puzzles before you can reach a boss.
Yeah, these puzzles aren't really that hard, and in my opinion, they are just fine. They aren't hard, but yeah, you have to do something for it. It's not just walking around, finding these doors to bosses, but yeah, it gives you something to do in between these boss fights. Well, in the first area there are none. In the second area there are a few. But
with the torches you have to light.
Yeah, well, that there are two that I remember, and those are the torches.
Yeah.
And in the maze, the kind of maze, you, it doesn't matter. Well, the puzzles are fun, and they're not game changing, breaking.
No. One thing I was missing in this game is a little bit of story.
Yeah, well.
Or even an objective, instead of kill every monster, every boss. There it wasn't at all.
No, not at all.
The ambience in the game is really cool. It's the pixel art really looks well. Yeah, it kind of gives a mysterious vibe, and that's why I would expect a little bit more story, but there isn't.
No, there is none at all. Yeah. Well, there is something going on, and you'll get to know it or at the end of the game. But
yeah.
You would like. There's nothing to it.
You would like to know why you are doing this.
Yeah. Yeah, but in the end, it also doesn't really break the game, right?
No.
Well, it's missing, of course, and I would love to see that in another version or sequel. But
yeah. Also, what would be cool was a co-op function.
Yeah, for sure.
But now what we did was, after we died, we would switch controllers, or after two deaths or something like that, or if you killed the boss, we would switch.
Yeah, and that's fine, but you can't co-op this game. You can do it, because you have to configure all the bosses.
Yeah.
So they would be too easy.
Yeah.
Because if someone is tanking him, shoot at his back and he's dead.
Yeah.
So the game would be too easy. Yeah.
Alright, conclusion. Is Titan Souls worth playing? What do you think?
Yeah, in my opinion, it certainly is. On each platform, it's only around 15 bucks, 15 euros.
Yeah.
And maybe you already have it in your library in your PlayStation, because it was free, I believe, a year ago, a year and a half.
Something like that.
So maybe you have it already. Check it out. It's a really cool game. I really loved it. Normally, I'm not really that Dark Souls kind of guy, just killing bosses. But this game, it feels good. All the bosses feel unique. They all have certain tactics to learn. And it's such an awesome game.
Yeah. I do have to say that I enjoyed it more when I was playing together with you.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
So it makes it more fun when you play with someone else.
Yeah.
And just switch around the controller.
You won't be as angry when you play.
Yeah,
with,
I think that's
people.
The most important part.
Yeah.
I'm actually a guy who rage quits really fast.
Yeah.
And I didn't have that with this game. So that says something, I guess. Alright guys, we would also like to know, did you like Titan Souls? Leave it down below in the comment section, and we'd hope to see you next time on Away From Keyboard.
Later guys.